Yeah, just 2 minutes. Maybe somebody want to come? Okay, I think we can start. So my name is Kirill, I think everybody knows. And today I want to tell a little about the textures, because it's important when you try to make something really special on the busts, especially on the busts, on the large size models, like 90 millimeters. It's important because you can show something really, really small, like precise details. And I think you just need to know a little about the fury, because especially the fury, it's something that can turn you, transform you from the ordinary hobbyist to somebody like artists, because it's attention to the small details, it's always important for authenticity. And I just want to show some pictures and speak about it, because all techniques that I use, it's very, very time consuming. And just 1 hour, it's not enough for show something really special, and it's not enough for explain, especially the painting technique. But I think especially the theory can help you, and I just show you several pictures and tell about what you can see. So first is the textures. When you see the textures from the distance, you see just the smallest spots of the different colors, and you just need to figure out that you see not only spots have some rules, have some physical law at the base, laying the base of this pattern. So, firstly, it's a picture visible from the different distances. From the far distance, you cannot see some kind of textures. You just can see something like big shades, big highlights, just big color spots. But when you go closer and closer, you start to see a lot of smallest details. So this is the first rule. When you paint something, you just need to figure out how is the distance. Maybe you just don't need to paint some kind of like texture. Maybe just need enough. Maybe it will be just enough to paint something like shades and highlights, because it's too far for see the smallest details. And this is effect of the scale. So if you paint something like 54 millimeters figure, maybe you just don't need to paint the texture, because it's too small for your idea, too small for your model, and you just can ignore it. So, the next picture. Yeah. The next picture shows especially the adaptation of this rule to the real miniature. This is a 90 millimeters model, and this is a 1:10 scale bust, and you can see that the texture already much visible here, because it's bigger, just bigger, and you can see a lot. And you cannot see something really good like here. You can see something like blurred spots, something like visible, just the spots. It's nothing special, just the spots. But when you can go closer, you can see something like this on the bust. And this is main meaning of this rule. And for show this texture, for paint this texture, you just need to figure out what you can see. Because everything that you can see around you is just reflected light. Everything, absolutely everything that you can see is reflected light. Every object, every surface just reflects the light, and you just need to know how different surfaces reflect the light. Depend on the quality of surface, and depend on the size, depend on the color, depend on the smoothness. Everything looks different, and you just need to figure out why you can see something like texture on the one surface and you cannot see textures on the another surface. Yeah. So here you can see the polished metal ball onto the textured surface, onto the raw, rough stone. And why you just can see something like a really good sharp reflections on the polished mirror like surface, and you cannot see reflections on the textured surface. Why is the meaning? So you just need to figure out that have the main rule of light reflection. So firstly, everything that you can see reflected light and angle of the falling light is equal to the angle of reflected light. Anyway, light from the light source falling to surface and will be reflected, but it may be reflected by the different way. So firstly, reflection from the smooth surface, like the polished metal ball, like the mirror, all falling light, all rays of light will be reflected on the same angle, absolutely every ray of light. And it means that you can see all light that will be falling and reflected from surface like a mirror. It's like a reflection into the mirror. It's very sharp and very clear, and you can see everything. But when you see something like a rough surface, like a textured surface, have another picture. So all this part of surface have the different angles. All kind of rough surface, like a cloth, like a wood, like a rough stone, have the really different angles, have too much of smallest elements of relief on the surface, and all the smallest elements of the relief will reflect the light on the different angles. So not all of this ray of light will be reflected directly to your eyes. Something will be just scattered around. And on the next picture, and on the next picture you just can see how it's working. So this is smooth surface like a mirror, this is rough surface like a texture. Everything, every ray of light falling to this surface will be reflected on the one direction, to your eyes. And on the roof surface it will be reflected to the different direction. And in result you can see something like blurred light, for example, blurred light spot, the blurred reflection. Anyway, it will be not so sharp like a mirror. You cannot see something like a sharp reflection onto the textured surface because too much of smallest element of relief that reflects the light. And it will be important if you want to show something like a matte woolen clothing, like a linen clothing, or like leather, or like, I don't know, suede, every kind of this surface, you just cannot reflect the light very well. And you just need to figure out that you cannot see something like a sharp reflection here. I just show another picture. It's a comparison of the differently polished surfaces. So the matte surface, rough matte surface, you cannot see something like sharp reflections like here. It's just physically impossible. On the other side, on something like semi-gloss surface, like leather, you can see something like bright reflection, but it will be not so sharp, not so estimated like on the mirror of the face. And in result, when you paint something, you can show it. When you paint something like different kind of materials, you can show it like, especially like different materials, when you will, where is the sharpness of reflection. You can paint something like blurred light spot on the matte surface, and result you receive something like a clothing. You can paint something like more bright red light reflection on the surface of the leather, and if you paint something like polished metal with the non-metal technique, you can paint especially this sharp reflection. But now it will be only about the matte surfaces, about the textures. I just show the difference between the polished surfaces like here. So on the big picture you cannot see some kind of texture. Everything that you can see is only reflection. It's not about the texture, it's about the reflection. In result, you don't need to paint something like visible defects, visible scratches, like a visible texture on the surface of the polished metal. But when you go to metal of not so good quality, like this, already will be visible some kind of defects, some kind of dents, scratches, different colors of material. Anyway, it already will look more interesting, more detailized. And you can compare these two objects. The brightness of these highlights, of this reflection of the light source, it's equal because it's semi-gloss surface. It's not so polished like mirror-like armor, but not so matte like a cloth. In result, you can see something like really bright reflection. And when you go to a completely matte surfaces, you already cannot see some kind of bright reflection. Everything will be dull, everything will be not so white and not so bright, but anyway you can see something like interesting texture on the surface. And everything, when I will talk about the textures, it's especially about these matte surfaces, like rusty metal, but mainly it's about the clothing like this. Because especially the clothing have something like very well organized texture. And for playing this texture, you just need to figure out how it was constructed, how it was produced. Because these elements, the smallest elements of texture, it's very important, especially for show the structure of material. The metal have no so visible structure, but something like clothing, something like a wool, already have the texture. But firstly, when you think about the texture, you just need to figure out that everything that you can see, it's just a combination of small volumes. All these small volumes make the sense about the texture, because it's something like a good visible structure, and as artist you just need to analyze the reference picture and figure out what you see on this reference picture. Because every time it will be not only color, it will be not only a pattern of the different color spots, it's also a combination of smallest 3D object. So the first, the main important rule about the texture. You just need to figure out that you see especially a combination of smallest 3D objects. It's not completely flat, it's a combination of the smallest objects. And you can apply this rule to the different kind of materials and try to figure out what you see on the reference picture, especially on estimated materials. For example, the most simple possible it's felt. Because it's random structure, it's very chaotical, it's a combination of the fibers just pressed and glued together. In result, you receive some just a combination of very simple color spots. It's totally random, it's have no orientation, it's have no structure, it's very random and it's just a combination of spots. The white spots, gray spots, any kind of this material you can see on something like, I don't know, like this Russian winter boots, Valenki. On the felted vests, any kind of this material, very rough, very thick, and you just need to know that it's very random. And how you can show it onto your model. For example, this 90mm Roman, I paint this cape, this glove, like felt, and I just use a very random structure, as I showed in the previous picture. It was just a combination of the prints. Something like just the prints of the brush, the tip of the brush, and it's very random. It was painted with oils, and especially this oil can show a very random structure, because acrylics, it's not about the randomness, it's about the control, but with oils you can show especially very random spots. And it's not so good visible because it's small scale, but on the upper part, where you can see the highlights, the shades and the midtones, you can see a lot of these spots. On the bottom part, you can see something like dirt, like a mud. And for show the rough and thick structure, I glue another kind of flock onto the edge of the cape, because it's very fricked and it's very, what's called it? It's scattered, it's damaged, and in result it has no sharp edge. Will be something like a puffy edge, because it's felt very thick. In result, it will be visible like something like a tip of the brush. It's especially like a brush. It's not sharp edge, it's puffy. And for sure, I glue especially the floor. But in the modern life, we almost not use the felt, and mostly it's about the glove. So what is a glove? The glove, it's a combination of the streaks. And all streaks will be weaved in some kind of knots. So when you see something like cloth, you always see the knots. And as I say, the texture is a combination of 3D objects. All these knots, it's especially what you can see on this pattern. In result, you can see the smallest volume. And if you can figure out what especially material you can see, is it canvas, is it burlap, is it tarpaulin, something like this, materials have the different pattern of the weaving. This is the most simple pattern that possible, it's something like a barrel. But the canvas is already a combination of the several streaks in each row, and it's just more complex. Yes. So, this is especially a different kind of weaving. For example, the canvas, it's very simple. Something like a wheel, it's already more complex. In result, from the distance, you can see some specially oriented pattern, like short lines on 35 degrees. And it looks like some very sharp estimated texture. In compare with the burlap, in compare with something like really soft material, like kind of like a silk, you can see a very good visible pattern. And this is just simple patterns. Without any kind of volumes, without any kind of shade and highlight. It's just a pattern for show, especially the way the whole material was fabricated, how it was made. In result, from the big distance, you just need to figure out how it was weaved and how affect this kind of weaving inflict to the shades and highlights on the surface of the material. And the next picture, it's especially material. So this is woolen cloth. It's very simple way of weaving, but material, it's very puffy. All streaks very puffy. And in result, you cannot see especially the structure. You can see something that looks like felt from the big distance. But anyway, it has some structure, has some volume. It's like, it's especially the volume of the small growth, small clusters of the fibers. But you cannot see a very well organized structure. You can see only something like a random combination of spots, like dots, but nothing that made something like visible lines, visible squares, something very random. The next picture, it's the same kind of material, but it's more fine, more precise, and here you already can see something like a structure. So vertical, horizontal lines that makes a grid, that make something like a net. But also, I don't know, is it visible from the back rows? Because it's especially about the smallest details. You can see the streaks very puffy, but it's not so puffy like on the previous picture. And you can see something like separate fibers, but also from the distance you can see some like something like a vector or pattern. It's like squares, but anyway it's not so good visible like on the canvas because streaks too puffy. And on the next picture it's how it looking in the real life on the reenactors. Yes. So the medieval reenactor, the Napoleonic era reenactor, you can see something like noise. It has no visible structure. It looks like noise, like a noise on the TV screen, the white noise on the TV screen, just a combination of the dots. And when you paint something like this, you don't need to paint it like lines. You just need to make something like a random spots, and it will be enough. And this is how it may look on the model. 1 to 10 scale busts, I make the zoom on the shoulder, especially for show the rough surface of the woolen cloth. It's very rough, it's very thick, and all you can see is just random dots, nothing more. You can compare it here with the canvas. On the canvas already has the visible structure because dots, it combined it with the lines. I will speak about it later, but you just need to figure out how the look of the woolen clothing in the large scale. And if you will combine the sizes, the contrast of these dots, you can receive the sense about the quality of material. For example, on this Swiss grenadier, you can see really rough cloth because all dots very contrasted. It very good visible compared to one with other because it's a combination of contrasting dots. On the other side, on the collar of officer grab coat, you also can see the dots, but it's not so contrasting. And in result, material looks like more fine quality material. Not so rough because dots not so good visible. So, for example, you can see clothing from the distance. It may be something like a regular shirt, for example, like a t-shirt, and you not always see the texture of material because it will be really thin streaks, really fine quality of material, and it means that you don't need to paint something like streak, something like dots. You just need to paint something like a gradient, the shades and highlights, and it will be enough. If you show especially the fine quality of material. But rough material always look more detailed, more interesting. It has some soul, it has some vintage looking, especially when you paint this kind of dots. Just the dots, nothing more. But if you paint really contrasting dots, it already will look like something old, something rough, something thick, because it has a different kind of fibers, some fibers, some streaks looks just more puffy compared with another. Any kind of this randomness makes the sense about the rough material. So another rule, when you paint something fine, you don't need to paint a lot of dots. But when you paint something like a rough, thick material, old material, you need to paint contrasting dots. In result, you receive the interesting structure. But any kind, you just need to figure out that it's a combination of the volume. So the next sample, it's a canvas. And I especially put this picture here because you can compare the direction of the lines. This is equal. It's not 45 degrees, it's not 90 degrees, it's like a 30 degree. So very good visible here on the metal orbs, metal squares, and you can see the same because these knots, the knots of the canvas, it's the same kind of orbs, the same kind of balls, but these balls, it's shiny, it's polished, and these balls, it's just matte, it's puffy matte balls, and all these balls combined in the good visible structure. I just repeat, you can see the direction of these lines, and this direction is equal here and here. So this is canvas, but canvas has a different level of quality. So these two materials very similar because it's a regular canvas, thick canvas, and this is burlap. The burlap already doesn't look like a combination of orbs, like balls. It looks like net because you can see a lot of gaps between all the streaks. And from the big distance, you can figure out that all these streaks have a different thickness because it's rough, it's low quality material. And all these streaks look very, very different. From the distance, one streak may look like thicker. In result, you receive something like a bright horizontal or vertical line. In result, you can see visible net, not random. It's something like a rough, really rough net. For example, here, here, and here have some visible bright spots. Why you see these bright spots? Because it's more thick line. You can see the thick line and smaller gap. In result, your texture looks like a combination of the horizontal and vertical line. When you go closer, you already can see that every separate combination of the streaks. Every separate dots, and these dots, it's just a gap between the streaks. But from the distance, you see just a combination of blurred, white, more bright lines. In result, it looks like net. Random net. The same kind of about the same kind of rule about the canvas, but the canvas look more structurized. It's not so random like burlap. It already has some really good visible structure. As I say, it's a line on 30 degree from some way from some point of view. You can see something like a horizontal line or vertical line, but mainly it's a line on the 30 degree. And it makes something like a rhombus. In result, this structure looks completely different than compared with this because it more structurized, it more estimated. This is random, this is more estimated. And how you can show this, this kind of material onto the surface of your model, for example. The rough burlap looks like more random structure, and the canvas you can paint like very well oriented dots. In result, you can receive especially visible difference between material onto the model. But firstly, you just need to know the structure of material. When you know the structure, you already can figure out how to paint the structure onto your model. But firstly, you just need to analyze what you see on the picture. Another kind of material, it's very rough tarpaulin, close to canvas. The meaning is the same. It's a combination of puffy orbs, 3D objects, puffy orbs, combined to the visible pattern, but some streaks looks thicker. In result, some streaks looks like lines, bright lines, like on the burlap. And from the distance, especially the roughness of this material, you can show when you will paint some dots more visible, bigger, just bigger dots. But anyway, structure very sharp estimated. It's combination of the dots, but some dots looks bigger, just bigger. Another picture, the same kind of material, but it's old. Yes. This is the same canvas, but you can see effect of peeling. On surface you can receive something like damaged streaks, and all these damaged streaks make this kind of random dots. So over the very well estimated structure you receive something like a very random different size of dots, and from the distance it will make some messiness, something like a disorder. And if you paint something like old canvas onto your model, you just need to make some disorder, especially with adding of random dots, the big random dots. Here you can see it very well, some streaks just was tired apart and it was repaired, and result, the structure will be broken. Will be broken in some spots. It will be not so good visible when you paint it on small scale, but when you go close to details, you can show especially the damaged places when the structure will be broken. And as I say, it will make some messiness. Another sample, it's a canvas, but on the military items of equipment, you can see the canvas has a different thickness, and sometimes on the backpack, for example, you can see the different kind of canvas. The regular canvas, it's not so thick. You can see from the distance, it doesn't look like texture, it's just looking like an ordinary gradient. But on the thick straps, you already can see the lines. And what is this lines? It's just a combination of really big knots of the streaks combined together in some visible structure. And when you paint it on the bust, for example, you can show this difference, like combination of texture. Of the different scale. For example, this is canvas of the ammo coaches. It's not so thick, but the canvas of the straps, it's much thicker. It must be a durable material, and the knots bigger. Just bigger knots make the bigger lines, the bigger dots. In result, you just don't need to paint something like a texture here, just a reminder of the texture, just a thin net, something like lines. But on the thick canvas, you can paint it like good visible spots. And from the distance, you can see that it's a different materials. It's a canvas, but you can see this canvas, it's really thick. Because you can see, you receive the sense of material, especially when you show the difference of the scale. So this is not the dots, this is dots, and result, the same material looks different. But need be very careful, because texturizing, it's not always looking good. For example, on this 1:6 scale action figure, this is natural material. And what's wrong with this model? It's absolutely regular material, it's physically correct, but it just looks too thick, because it's impossible to reach really the same thickness in the same scale. For example, the real streak has a thickness 1 millimeter. When you make something like clothing for this model, you just need to shrink the thickness. You must receive the sixth part of the thickness. It's something around 0.15 millimeters. So the streaks must be thinner, much thinner, especially for receive the same sense about the texture. But what you can see here, the really thin streaks will be just magnified. It will look thicker because it's like 1 millimeter streaks will be puffed to the six millimeter streaks. In result, you can see the really big knots. So these knots, these points, just bigger than possible to receive in the scale. But it's just impossible to receive the smaller because it's real material, it's a real fabric. It's just a sewed item, and it just looks too rough. It's impossible. It's good for the doll, it's good for the action figure, but it's not good for the painted part. And as artist, you can avoid this incorrection because textures that you paint onto your models, it doesn't limit the thickness of the streaks. It limited only by your skill and only by the thickness of the tip of the brush. And sometimes you can paint it smaller. For example, here you can see the visible spots, but when you will paint it, you just don't need to paint any kind of spots because it will be just too small. Too small for see it from this distance, to see it from this scale. So sometimes you just don't need to paint any kind of texture, or maybe you just need to paint something like lines instead of dots. So it's on your own. You just need to figure out, can you see this texture from in the scale from this distance or not? Because here you can avoid it because it just exists, because it's material. But when you paint it, you can paint it or not paint it, especially for receive the right sense about the texture, especially the sense, especially the right view, the view from the big distance. Another material, it's a cotton and denim. Actually, absolutely the same combination like with the canvas, but separate streaks, smaller in result, especially the dots, it's almost not visible. But you can see especially the combination of the lines. So when you paint something like cotton jackets for the military figures, German figures, you just can paint it like a combination of the lines. Sometimes vertical or horizontal.